Hello, hello, and welcome to Crypto Media Services. My name is Martin. I'll be your host today, where the program is all about gaming.
Crypto Media Service, bringing you in-depth thoughts on cryptocurrencies.
First of all, I want to apologize for no article this week. This is because we have server problems and we will focus on getting our servers back up and running. Once they're back up and running at full power, we will of course be back with many more articles. But first of all, our servers need to be running so we can deliver good articles to you, good content. But let's jump over to our website, which is still running. We can just not access it. We will fix that. Hopefully within 1 to 2 weeks, it will be totally up and running. Until then, you will have to... What's it called? This is the only way we can communicate with you. This is coming in via a secondary computer we have, which we make videos on. That's why we can still make our videos. But let's jump over to the website. So we can talk. This is an article we had up about the cryptocurrency, blockchain, and gaming. So let's start by jumping to DMarket, which is the first blockchain-based trading market we have in our article. Since I started working on this, they have actually added Dota 2. This makes the market a little bigger. Currently, the DMarket is using a blockchain and cryptocurrencies. But you will notice that the price is offered in USD, which I like. I like that I have something to compare it to. And the more I can use cryptocurrencies in the background and USDs and all other things, all other things in the foreground, the better. Currently, Dota 2 and CSGO is the only thing traded. But this gives transparencies in order to trade the items forth and back between players. And you will see, let's just take a random gun here. You can go over here and check out the price development the last 7 days. How many is on sale and all of that. But also, has it been used? This has been field tested. They all have been field tested. It's an SMG, it's a P90. You have full control and full overview. There's no market stats here and no reviews. And you can explore the blockchain directly from their site. There you will be able to see what transaction has been on the blockchains. Two in the last time. And you can see they have a little bit of time between each block. There's not many people using it. There will be need to be shorter times between the block when, and I stretch, when it becomes more attractive to trade on here. I might recommend that you have a wallet. Blockchain wallet, like DMarket wallet, if you're using the two games, Dota and CSGO. There's not much else to say about this. If you know about blockchain, if you know about cryptocurrencies, you'll understand much of what is going on here. So let's get back to the article. And we will go on to the next thing, the one I am most keen on, BitGuild. BitGuild is not yet open for trading, but they have had a token sale, a total sale of 4.5 billion plat, which is their coin, and 548,000 of them were burned. Then there were 3 billion, well, 3.5 billion in private sales, and 451,000 in public. What triggers me about this is that there were such a big private sale. But it is promising. What I like about this is that you can trade in-game items, that all game items will be traded via smart contract, which means I can load up the item on the contract. Once, if you want to buy my item, once you pay, I get the delivery of the plat coin, and you get delivery of the items. This way we need not trust each other. You do not need to wait until I transfer the items, and I do not need to wait until you transfer the funds. The contract takes care of that. An auction house, a virtual asset created on the BitGuild portal, can be bought and sold for plat on their auction house, which, well, you can make auctions still using the smart contract. The plat token is an ERC20 token and can be used to buy and sell items in the auction house, but it will also be used to support game incubators projects in the game incubator. And to jump on to the game incubator, it's for player to player and player to developer interactions. It is also for crowd sale. If you have a small gaming company, you would like to make a good game, you can use the incubator to incubate your game, which means you work on it and get some funds out of it if someone wants to support you. But also that, well, it gives a chance to the game developers who are not that big. And this, as long as you expect to put your items up in BitGuild, they're happy. Because it needs to be connected to the BitGuild blockchain. The item wallet, which I find has some extreme good potential. In a traditional wallet, you will have, example, Bitcoin. Here you will have your plat tokens, you will have your items. So if you buy a super cool armor on BitGuild for, let's say, just an example, 100 plat, the 100 plat will be transferred out of your wallet once the smart contract has gone through. You will get your armor into your wallet and can then transfer it into your game. Cool. I like it a lot. It will give, all of this will together give you a transparent transaction. No need to trust the one you're buying it from. No need to make obscure deals and hope for the best. So let's just see what they're saying about themselves.
This is you, the gamer. Like most gamers, you just want to press play and get right into the action. But you're getting tired of all these annoying restrictions in your games. More and more, developers and publishers are pushing unfair systems on you, designed to produce minimum effort content for maximum profit, at your expense. To solve this, we created BitGuild, a platform built for gamers by gamers, that puts the control back into the hands of players and forever changes the way the gaming world works. Say you've got a very special sword in your favorite game. You love your sword, and your sword loves you. The problem is that all games must come to an end eventually, right? Maybe the servers are shutting down, or perhaps you just want to play a different game. What happens to your sword then? Currently, it disappears. Forever. Bye, sword. But not anymore. On BitGuild, you can take that sword with you into another game. You can display it as a memento or even sell it. It's all up to you. With BitGuild, all in-game assets, items, and accounts exist on the blockchain, which means ownership belongs to you, the players. Pair this with an affordable, open marketplace where players can easily and safely trade with others, and you've got something with the potential to change games as we know them. No longer will you have to play in the shadow of greedy publishers as they control your fun with overbearing terms of service agreements that seem like they were written by an evil corporate overlord, forcing abusive virtual currency systems into your games, controlling your items and accounts, just to prey on your love of games for their profit. All our games will utilize smart contract technology and accept Plat as a payment method. Game items will be tokenized, making them player-owned and tradable. And, unlike old-school cryptocurrency wallets, our wallet allows for the visual display of item tokens as well as Plat. It's more like an inventory than a wallet. Get, buy, sell, trade, and own your virtual items, for real, with BitGuild. Take back your games and join the guild.
And let's move on to the roadmap. Before that, I will just comment on their video. I like the idea a hell of a lot. That I can take my items from game to game. I own my items. It is not the companies who own them. This makes it quite ingenious. So let's move on to their roadmap in Q8 initial portal development. In Q2 of this year, BitGuild official launch. BitGuild the game official launch. Item wallet and auction house. Q3 external studio game developments. Q4 5 to 6 blockchain games on BitGuild portal. Portal and games localized into 5 languages, BitGuild Game Incubator beta launched. So if you have something for the Game Incubator, you might get in on the beta, or you might wait to 2019 Q1, where the Incubator official launch, and they are 10 to 12 games. And in Q2 of 2019, 15 plus games. There seem to be quite a lot of games they want on it. I never put much into who's featuring them. But there are some good names here. But to return to the roadmap, it sounds a little compressed. I hope they can keep up their timetable, but I do believe that it will take them a little longer time. But as long as they are working on and developing on it, I do believe in this project. And it should be said, I have not invested in any tokens in it. And nor am I planning to until they fully launch. And we will just jump over to the team. You can just watch the team here. I will not go into depth with each of them. But let's just take the size of the team. The size of the team is not that big. But I like the size. It is not too small. It is not a giant team. And in our next video, you will be able to follow as we research each of the characters, or not characters, each of the persons involved in the BitGuild and see if they are fake persons or real persons. I do believe they are real persons, and you will see how I come to that conclusion in next week's video. And, well, Justin Soon, you know him if you know about Tron. So it's a good advisor to have. Chairman and CEO of KSV Esport, Kevin Chow. You know of him. We will go in to see if he's mentioning BitGuild. We will see how once we begin our investigations. And Leo Wang, founder partner of Free Angel. I know of him. I don't know if you know of him, but he is an interesting character. And he's an interesting to see if he's mentioning it. Until then, and until next week we will look into BitGuild's members and see how possible is it for them to make this BitGuild work. And so that's it for today. Have a great week, and I hope to see you again in 1 week when we are diving into BitGuild members. Remember to leave a like, subscribe. If you didn't like this video, leave a dislike, so I know I need to do better. Thank you for watching. Have a great week.